This show is part of the Drowning Man Podcast Network. Visit drowningmanpodcasts.com.
Ooh, wow, we made it to 5 o'clock and still no texts from anyone who needs us to save Christmas or anything. I think we're going to actually have this party.
That's where you and I disagree.
Okay.
We cannot have any party until we have the giant ice sculpture in place. So would you go grab that out of the back room? I'd appreciate it.
Yeah, sure. One thing, The whole ice sculpture thing.
Yeah, the giant ice sculpture.
So we got the ice delivered.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really big.
Mm-hmm.
Like, yeah. Super duper big.
Yeah.
Like, not super safe to be moving around big.
It's ice. It's slippery. Just push it out.
Okay. It's just that it's also, we had the sculptor come in, and he did the thing you wanted him to do. Carved it into the giant naked guy with the ball.
Atlas. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And it's really... It's really off balance.
No, because he would have dropped it by now. He's actually really well balanced, and that's kind of the thing. That's why, also why he's naked. It shows the human physiology.
Okay.
And like how he's strongly holding the entire world on his shoulder.
Right. It's just that when you have
well balanced.
Yeah, it's just that here in you know our physics, he's not a real dude. He's a piece of ice with like two little legs made out of ice. And then this huge top heavy portion.
Right.
That, you know, if we push too hard anywhere, it's just going to fall over.
Okay. Well, you get underneath and we'll do a piggyback situation.
Oh, this is getting worse. Okay. Yeah. Well,
I'll help.
Okay.
I'll push from back.
Sure, yeah.
You'd be up that's front with him kind of lean over.
One way we could do it. We could also maybe just have that be the feature of the room it's in.
What room is it in?
It's in the garage.
I don't think we were gonna use the garage for anything except for the
kickstand. Now we can. We've opened up this whole additional space to use for the party.
Well, I mean,
and it would be a real shame. I think it would be a real shame if no one got to see that beautiful ice sculpture that you commissioned.
I see you and I have different ideas of what's shameful, but I'll let it be. So in that case, I guess I'll just ask that you finish doing the decorations with all the tinsel. I know you were going around earlier with a big bag full of tinsel. You were spreading it on the tree.
Yeah.
The boughs and the wreaths and everything.
Yeah,
but I noticed you very carefully avoided my Jacob's ladder demonstration. And I really think that it could use some tinsel too. So if you just throw that on there, I'd appreciate it.
Okay. Yes. I did avoid the big thing with an arc of electricity traveling regularly in the middle of it. Yes. Mm-hmm.
John, our roles here were very clear. Mm-hmm. I put some of the pine boughs down here and there.
Mm-hmm. You did a great job with that. It's very well dispersed.
Thank you. That is my goal, is to disperse the pine boughs.
Mm-hmm.
I also turned on some of the lights.
Yes.
You were in charge of tinsel.
Mm-hmm.
I think if you look at the Jacob's ladder, you'll see there are some assorted lights scattered around it. There is a miniature wreath mounted. I use super glue, mounted it to the base of the Jacob's ladder.
Yeah.
I think that's a little bit singed.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. No tinsel.
No tinsel. So you want me
I'm
to...
I'm not feeling festive.
So where on the Jacob's ladder would you like me to put the tinsel?
Interesting. You didn't ask where on the pine boughs. You just did it.
Right. Because the pine boughs, I feel like there is a significantly lower probability of the pine boughs electrocuting me in any way if I throw tinsel on them.
You keep going back to this electricity thing.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Because do you want me to turn off the Jacob's ladder while you decorate it?
That might help.
Okay.
I do worry about when you turn it back on, if there will be an explosion.
Mm. Sounds like a science experiment to me. 'Tis the season.
Okay, why don't you go ahead and turn it off then?
Okay. Oh, no. That's the door.
Oh.
Gotta leave the Jacob's ladder on. Otherwise, people won't see it.
Good point.
Who's getting the door?
I think Cody is.
Okay.
Man, Dave and John get to do all the fun stuff. Play with electricity and tinsel and all that fun stuff. Answering the stupid door. It sucks. Oh, our first guest. Old Lady Jitters, hello, welcome to the party.
Oh, hello.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well, a little bit cold out.
It's like 82.
Yes, I don't care for it. It's got to be 95 or above for me, or else I got to wear all these sweaters.
That's a hellscape. Yeah. Anyway, welcome to the party. Did you bring the stuff?
Oh, yes. I don't go to any parties without drugs.
That's good. That's going to make this party way better. Anyway.
Right to the back?
Oh, you know. Okay. You know your spot. Oh, another one so quickly. How unexpected. Ah, Count Chocula. How's it going?
Going great, man. Yeah. So I brought this chocolate surfboard.
How do you make these?
I make them with chocolate.
Okay, I asked for that. That's fair.
Yeah. So I take the chocolate.
Uh huh.
And I say, hey, chocolate.
Mm-hmm.
I am Count Chocula.
Mm-hmm.
Be a surfboard, okay. And it just does it, man.
Still very astounding.
I'm so happy I killed that vampire.
As are the people of that village. Anyway, come on in. You're like the second person here, so make yourself comfortable.
Rad, bro.
Ah, Captain Quarterback. Hello. Thank you for showing up.
Sup.
So, how's it going? How's the, you know, the team?
It's okay. The team went to finals this year, and I got a third girlfriend.
Wow, a third one.
Yeah, third one ever.
Oh, not like concurrently.
Nah, bro, it's not me, man. You know me, I'm devoted.
That's true. Yeah, the monogamy's always been your strong suit.
Hopelessly devoted to you.
Yeah, Old Lady Jitters is here. She's ready for your duet if you want to start warming up.
That's cool, man. I always come in for the karaoke.
Yeah, we know.
And, you know, a little bit of flag in the back.
Yeah, most people have recovered from their injuries from last year, so you should have quite a team.
Oh, cool, man. I'm starter, right?
Yes, Captain. You're cool. You're Captain Quarterback. You're starting.
Cool.
You want to go start stretching it out?
Yeah, I'll get right into the keg stands.
I'm not surprised.
In the garage?
Sure. Watch out for the ice thing. He's got a huge testicle on his back. I don't know. Esteban the Pirate, what are you doing here?
Arr, I be bringing in all these burritos for your party.
Oh, burritos are the best. You got the special ones?
Oh, I did. I did bring you the tamale-flavored burritos.
It's the best. It's food that tastes like itself. I can't believe it. How did you find these?
Well, I went and I made tamales with my own 1.5 hands.
I was going to say, that half hand is looking nasty.
Yeah. And then I took the tamales that I made with my own 1.5 hands and I wrapped them up in a tortilla like a burrito.
Oh, okay. That's really clever.
And I brought them here.
Okay, yeah, that's what you're carrying.
Aye.
Okay, that's excellent. Anyway, you want to go put him next to one of the microwaves? Do they need to be microwaved or toaster ovened, or is there a preference? A lighter holding?
I expect if we were to light a grand pyre over the skulls of our enemies.
Okay.
And lightly toast them over that. That should have the desired effect.
Okay. Did you bring any enemies?
I'm sure I can find some.
Classic Esteban. Get your ass in there.
All right. Kitchen's this way?
One of them is. I don't fucking know. I don't work here. see who's next. Ah, Sven, Viking Conqueror of All. Hello.
That is right.
How's it going, man?
Yes, I'm here. I'm playing the game of a Christmas time, and I have a Holly Jollies.
I'm sure you do. The horns look magnificent.
Thank you. I had them polished.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, they do have a luster about them.
A luster of midday, I read.
You do read that, I'm certain.
Yes.
Yeah, it's like afternoon, but that's fine. That's cool.
Yes.
Did you bring the weapons? I thought I remember you were doing some demonstration-y stuff.
Yes, I have them in my trunk.
Mm-hmm.
I can bring them at any time. Some of them are not so good for cold weather.
Really?
Yeah.
Why not?
Well, you know, if you touch bare metal with a hand in cold, it's really cold.
That was deep. We can probably get Casey to lick one. That'll be funny.
Ah, Casey is a funny guy.
Sometimes intentionally.
He is one of the funniest.
He is. He's a hilarious human being. That Casey.
Yes, anyone who gets a nose ring like that, you know. Very funny. My kind of guy.
I'm sure he's back there somewhere, Sven, Viking Conqueror of All. You want to bop on back and start stabbing people a little bit?
Eh? I will. That's... I will do that.
I'm glad.
Very good.
Wow, another one. I didn't think we'd have guests for this long. Thog. How you do, Thog?
I do good. You Thog do good.
Okay, awesome.
Thog do good.
Okay.
With the heavy thing.
Yes. Yeah, we need
made
that.
Made of cake.
Dense cake is the best.
Yes, also fruits.
Oh, Thog, I told you.
But Thog, take out little hard bits of fruits.
That's good.
And put only soft, good parts of fruit in cake thing.
Right. No, I appreciate that. Just you said you were going to make a meat cake this year.
Thog also put meat in cake.
No, in the same cake as the fruit?
Yes, is sweet and savory at same time.
Okay.
Much foodie.
Yes, thank you, Thog.
He's on blog.
Hey, Cody.
Yes, Dave.
Is that Thog?
It is.
Did he bring a fruitcake?
In a sense. Yes, you know, yes, he did. The answer to that question is yes.
All right.
Meaty fruitcake.
Thank you, Thog.
Yeah. Have him keep it separate from everything else.
I'll do my best, but you know Thog, once he puts his mind to something. Thog, just put it anywhere. It'll piss off Dave, it's hilarious.
Thog put on wreath
on
by big, strong Iceman's nether regions.
That was surprisingly reserved of you, Thog. Anyway, yeah, have fun playing with the ice stick.
Fuck yes!
Well, yes, hello? Dave Clone? Hey, Clone Dave!
Hey.
I thought we destroyed you.
No, Dave would never let me get destroyed because I need to step in for him after he loses interest.
Right.
So that it appears that he's maintaining interest in the entire party throughout.
Okay. Did you fix that whole organ thing?
No, I'm a clone of Dave. I'm not more interested in helping than he is.
No. Okay. Yeah, I guess that's... Wait, so why are you helping then if you're the same level of, like, disinterest?
I'm kind of stuck to it since he created me.
I mean, dude, just do what you want. You're a free clone. It's a free America, man. You could go be apathetic anywhere.
Yeah, fuck that guy.
Ooh, real Dave's gonna be mad.
Yeah, I am.
Oh, wait, which one are you?
Hmm?
Okay, I have to shoot one of you to figure out which one is the real one.
Yeah, go ahead and shoot me.
That's definitely the real Dave. John, do we have any of the Washington whiskey stuff? I want to spike the punch.
You know, I think that we used all of that to kill Uncle Sam.
Oh.
But since we're on the subject,
yeah.
What are all these burritos doing in here?
Oh, these are like tamale burritos. I was gonna cook them up and then just kind of put them around the place and see who eats them.
Hey guys.
Hey there.
What's up?
We're just putting the finishing touches on dinner here.
Something's burning.
Oh, Yeah?
Yeah.
What?
I don't know.
Oh. Something's burning?
Yeah, isn't it exciting?
Cody, have you been watching the digital read thermometer over there?
I can't read. You know. That's why
it's digital read.
I can't read digital. Sorry, that's what I meant to say. I can't read digital things.
Okay, well, Analog's no problem. I told you that as soon as that reads 165 degrees, that means the gravy is done.
I have 165 proof alcohol somewhere. I'll be right back.
Oh, my God.
Did you want me to check on something?
You could if you want to.
The gravy? Is that what it was?
The gravy, yeah.
Okay, it turns out I drank all the 165. I have some 151. If you guys want to do shots real quick.
Dude.
Yes.
Have you already been doing some shots? I mean, you're acting a little bit cooked here.
Yes. Yes, I have.
All right, let me go get my glass.
Okay. Do you want some? Okay. Oh, what if we take the turkey and we marinate it in 151, and then when it cooks, it'll be all like, whoa, alcohol turkey.
Here we go.
Awesome. Wait, are you the real Dave or are you clone Dave?
Ah, shit. Clone Dave.
Your goose is cooked, clone Dave. Get out of here.
Okay, so, wait.
Yeah.
The turkey hasn't even been marinated yet?
Well, no. That's why you marinate it in alcohol so it marinates faster. That's just physics, Sean.
Okay, but it was supposed to be cooking by now.
Right.
And so you, here I am. Why are you looking at me like that?
All right. Here you go, real Dave.
Real? What do you mean? Oh, God. Is my clone here?
Yeah. Okay, he figured it out. We're good.
Who invited him?
I don't know. Oh, did you get that frosted glass from the fridge? You're not supposed to do shots out of those. Those are supposed to free
for beer. Hang on. No. Oh. Esteban, put that down. No flaming arrows in the house.
I thought we rescinded that rule.
No, it's all in the house. It's always been.
Really?
That way, yeah.
Ooh. Now I have some destruction to cover up. Anyway, let's blend some cranberries.
Yeah, and that makes gravy, right?
Sure, it does. Oh, Esteban has something on fire. I'm going to roast marshmallows.
Yeah, the cranberry gravy is my favorite part of Thanksgiving.
We don't have any marshmallows. Why would I think that I could roast marshmallows in the house? We don't have any marshmallows.
Don't we?
No.
Oh.
We just have gravy.
Did you check the fridge? I like to keep them cold.
I did. I stored marshmallows in my room
last Christmas. Okay, guys. So we need to get the turkey in the oven right now.
Why?
Because otherwise dinner is not going to be ready anywhere near on time.
I thought you were the one in charge of the turkey. Isn't it done yet?
It is, marinating. I'm gonna...
Now?
Yes.
I thought you were supposed to put it in the oven for that. Don't you marinate it at a specific temperature for a specific duration, and then you pull it out and it's done marinating?
That's what you do when you cook it.
Okay, I lost interest. I'm gonna go do a cake stand real quick.
Anyway, I have to start all over on the gravy anyway.
Okay, they weren't marshmallows. They were after dinner mints. I should not have tried to roast them over the open flame. That was
gross. Why are there all these cranberries in the blender?
Oh, we were going to blend them with something. What do we have lying around we can blend with cranberries?
There's a turkey.
You always want to blend the turkey, John. Let's get creative for a change. Like, let's cook the turkey and then blend something else.
There's this charcoal that used to be gravy.
Hey!
Charcoal used to be gravy.
Kitchen. Kitchen.
Ooh, hold on. No, that gives me an idea. I'll be right back. Here's something
I'm in the kitchen. I have a question for the kitchen.
Okay.
Why am I finding corn husks in my burrito?
That's a really good question.
I thought it was worth asking.
I'm going to go ask Esteban.
Okay. Hey, Cody, thanks for jumping in the security office here with me.
No problem. I don't know why we have this. This place is not secure at all.
No, it's not secure, but we do have lots of cameras, and that's what I want to show you. Nice. I went and checked the DVR.
Yeah.
Here's where the ice is.
Oh.
The ice sculpture.
This is not what I thought. Okay.
I went back and I scrubbed through all of the footage.
Mm-hmm.
John never even tried to move it.
Was he supposed to? I mean, it's John.
That Atlas statue was supposed to be in the living room.
He can barely push the envelope, let alone an ice sculpture.
I'm just really disappointed, that's all.
That's okay. And, you know, he's probably used to it by now.
Okay, I just think maybe we should, like, vote to kill him or something. Oh. Do we have to take this?
I think we're in a security office. We have to take it. It's a security call. Maybe. I don't know.
It's not a secure line, though.
Oh. So we can say whatever we want. Also, I vote yes to kill John.
Hello?
Oh, hi there, boys.
Who's that, Dave? Dave.
Oh, it's Waverly. It's Waverly, boys. Oh. You know, Waverly Rudigore the Third.
Oh, the male stripper.
Are you the male stripper? The guy that goes and takes all the stamps off?
Isn't that illegal?
Yeah. He's wanted. He's a wanted man.
Wow.
You know, I did do that for a little while, but now I'm mostly a taxidermist by trade.
Taxed man.
Oh, I can't talk to tax people.
So I take the little woodland creatures after they've died, and I remove their innards and replace their innards with various other materials to pose them in amusing ways.
This guy sounds metal as fuck.
I thought that he was something interesting, but he's just metal as fuck.
Yeah. He's a murder sculptor.
That's cool.
Or a death sculptor.
And so
are
anyway,
you a murder sculptor or a death sculptor?
So anyway, I'm on the way to the party.
Are you a metal sculptor or a death sculptor?
I mostly deal in chipmunks.
Metal.
Though I have done some pigeons also.
Okay. What?
How sounds like he does both.
Okay.
Cool. What's the deal?
Well, I'm on the way to the party, and I seem to have gotten all turned around. You know, these old, back roads to your place.
Yeah.
And I just need some help with directions.
Okay. Have you been using a steering wheel?
I've actually had my steering wheel replaced with a joystick. I have very fond memories of being, in my 40s in the 1980s.
Okay, can you please hold?
And playing flight simulator.
He's got a joystick in his car? That's cool.
I just want to know the general protocol in the security office. Are we allowed to hang up or do we have to stay to the end? Is it like a telephone call from a salesperson?
Yeah, I signed that contract with the security company.
Okay.
I think. I signed something.
Okay.
It was all in digital. I couldn't read it.
I'm going to start listening to what he says then.
That's probably a good idea.
We can end this.
Okay.
Okay. All right.
And then we kill John.
Told Bill Gates, no. Hello? No, you're not allowed Hello? To have sex with my gerbil.
Hello?
Oh, yeah. Hi. Yes?
All right.
But yes, I have a joystick in my car.
Sorry, were you just talking about having sex with a gerbil?
That's not metal.
Bill Gates was talking about that. I told him no.
Uh-huh. But it's dead and you put some sort of stuffing in it, right?
That is what I do now, yes, but this was the 1980s.
Oh, before taxidermy was invented.
Wasn't it?
I get it.
Okay. Anyway, Winnemucker Studebaker, where are you right now if you're coming to the party?
I'm on a lonely dirt road somewhere out in the wilderness. There is a large tree that looks sort of... It reminds one of sort of a voluptuous lobster.
Oh, shit.
But with leaves on it.
By the lobster tree.
When you say voluptuous, Dave. Does that mean hot and sexy?
It means full-figured, curvy, I think, is the lingo.
I'll Google it.
He's
thick, even, I think I've heard people say.
Uh-huh.
Dave, there are booby traps by the lobster tree.
That's what it sounds like. I'm Googling it, and I'm not finding a map result.
Well, I mean, we named it Lobster Tree. It's not like an official name or anything.
You didn't go onto Google Maps and name it?
No. I figured just like if I projected my will into the universe, it would change.
Why do you even have a will? You're not dead. Do you have any other like road signs that you can see?
There is a sign. There's an open trench. Near the lobster tree.
Ah, trenchy.
And the sign by the open trench says, danger, open trench.
That was my idea.
Okay, I'm going to put you on hold again. Hold on a second.
All right.
Do you know where this guy is? You seem to know everything about it.
I mean, I know what booby traps are near him.
Uh-huh.
There's the lightning arc thing. There's the spikes. There's the razor discs. There's the lightning razor discs. There's the rattlesnakes.
Yeah, but so you're saying, you keep saying like you put this there or you named that. So where is he?
North-ish somewhere. Remember that bender a couple months ago I went on? I didn't show up for weeks?
No.
Oh. All right, then.
You have to be more specific.
The third one in July.
Yes.
Now I was booby trapping the property. A lot of it.
Oh, so he's here then.
Yeah, somewhere.
Somewhere on the compound.
Yeah. But there are a lot of booby traps and some that I don't remember putting there. I just remember me and Trenchy had a couple secrets about what booby traps I was going to lay. So he might run into some weird stuff.
Okay. Hey.
Hey there. What do you know about these exploding blow up dolls that I keep finding?
Oh, yeah.
They are not worth the emotional investment.
All right. Well, this one I named Doreen.
Okay.
Would you like to speak with her?
Oh, sure, yeah.
All right, Doreen.
Hello?
Doreen doesn't want to talk, actually.
Hi, Doreen. Are you on speaker?
That's Phyllis. What a whore.
Who's Phyllis?
Well, he's calling her Doreen, but it's Phyllis.
There's only one of them?
Well, there's only one named Phyllis.
Oh, okay. It's a good pun.
It's a what?
So how do I get to the party?
I think you're here. You just have to find your way to the meeting hall portion.
All right. So should I drive over the snakes or around them?
Do you have an open vehicle or is it closed?
It's
like an open Jeep or a convertible.
Oh, it's a Cadillac convertible, of course.
Top down.
Top down. Why would I have a convertible if I was going to drive around with the top up?
No, I get it.
I mean, for fuck's sake.
The 80s. So top down is perfect for that. I was just curious. Around.
The snakes?
Around the snakes. All right, I will go around the snakes. Should I... So there's the snakes, and on one side, I'm going to say the north side of the snakes, there is a pit full of spikes. Uh-huh. On the south side of the snakes, there is something that looks like a lightning disc,
uh-huh,
sort of flying around in the air menacingly.
Uh-huh.
Which way should I go around the snakes?
Boy, it's really... perfectly parallels the old trolley problem, doesn't it? You go one way, people die. You go the other way, other people die. Oh, no, it's you.
He can go through.
Try to find a security robot named 3B. Do we still have 3B?
Maybe. I think he got mad at me and rebooted something.
Hold on. Hey, sir, we're going to put you on hold one more time. Sorry.
All right. Well, I was going.
John?
Oh, yeah.
What's John, up? Do we still have 3B?
Yeah, we still have 3B.
We got him back from the government and all that?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, there's a 3D printed replica of him in the city of Ho Chi Minh, but...
That's not here, is it?
The original is back here with us.
Oh, okay, great. That's all. You should leave now.
Okay.
Don't look at the screen.
Don't look at any of the screens.
Well, I've got to finish up on the turkey anyway.
I know, I was watching.
Go all cook right. That turkey.
Thank you.
Sir?
And so I told Barbara that she cannot, under any circumstances, do the cocaine because it would ruin her entire message.
Oh my God, that's a sad story.
Is it? Nobody did cocaine.
Ruined message. Could you imagine?
No. Like, literally incapable.
How are you supposed to de-stress?
You should go get him, and then you should jump in the pit of spikes, Dave.
Who?
Thibodeau Crumbly Bunch, the guy who's trying to drive here in his pink Cadillac.
I'll send clone, Dave. We're going to send a clone.
Oh, smashing!
Yeah, watch out for that, too. Smashing things. There's a smashing trap.
So, Mr. Chocula, I was curious about that little boogie board you've got.
Oh, yeah, the surfboard?
Yeah, where did you find such a thing?
Well, I didn't find it, I made it.
No shit.
Oh, yeah, no, like, check it. I was in the Transylvania area.
Oh, yes, been there.
And, like, there's this castle and a vampire lived in it?
Oh, yes, he and I know each other.
Oh, you know the vampire?
Yes, haven't seen him in a while, but...
Well, he's dead now.
We've been... No, that's a common mistake. He's actually undead.
Oh! Look, so, check it. Here's what happened.
Checked.
Yeah, so, I went to his castle.
Yes.
And he was like the count of all the chocolates. Mm. Like, chocolate powers.
Not gonna lie, part of why I loved him.
Yeah, no, I loved him too. But then, like, he tried to suck all the chocolate out of me. I don't got a lot of chocolate in my blood.
No.
So, like,
not enough.
That little chocolate, like, if he had taken all the chocolate out of my bloodstream, like, I would have died.
Oh.
So, like, I had to, like, kill him.
Oh.
And then, like, the craziest shit happened. Like, when he died, I got all his chocolate powers.
Did you?
So, like, I just, like, looked at the chocolate, and I said, bruh, chocolate, bruh. Would it be rad if you were a chocolate surfboard? And chocolate, like, just became a surfboard. Like, I got chocolate powers now, man.
That's amazing. You got all of his chocolatey powers?
I think so, yeah.
Very interesting. What do you think about that?
I don't know. I'm just here to juggle chainsaws. Wait, somebody wanted to carve an ice sculpture.
Yes.
And so I brought my chainsaws, and it's already carved. So I figured I'd just start doing the juggling thing. But if we're talking about chocolate, I can carve chocolate too.
What's the most amount of the most dangerous thing you've ever juggled?
Oh, there's a lot of questions in one sentence.
But only one sentence.
That's technically correct. The most dangerous amount of the most things I've ever juggled. Oh, wait, alive or dead? Or like alive or inanimate?
Can you juggle?
Actively running.
Can you juggle?
I juggle what?
Peaches.
Oh, you mean like the small fruit?
Yeah, like kind of fuzzy.
Yes. Yeah, I believe I could juggle some peaches.
That'd be rad, man.
That would be radical.
Yes. Yeah, it would. No, one time I juggled bobcats. What, that's... You guys never seen a bobcat juggle?
Actively running bobcats?
Yeah, they were on some kind of experimental drug.
Wow, I've been to construction sites. I've seen bobcats at work, but I didn't imagine anyone could juggle those.
I'm pretty strong. I look deceptively weak, I know. Looking at myself.
Did they have the backhoe attachment?
No, it was the big claw thing.
Oh.
Bruh, check it.
Like a crane machine.
I bet I could make the chocolate be a bunch of bobcats for you. You could juggle that.
And then I could, like, take bites out of them as I'm juggling chocolate running bobcats.
If you could do that, that would be amazing.
That'd be the raddest shit ever, man.
And I'm old.
You are.
I've seen lots of things.
What are you, like 100?
I'm like 100. Exactly.
So wouldn't the answer to that question be no?
No.
Okay.
Is that what you wanted to hear?
Sure. Can you make the engines run?
I don't know, man. I haven't tried.
Like chocolate engines?
So, chocolate. Be bobcats now. And with engines that run.
That's
quite admirable. An incantation.
Admirable attempt. They are running.
Yeah.
They're just not as big.
You know what this means?
They're bob kittens.
We need more chocolate.
Yes. Let's get more chocolate.
Well,
chocolate run.
Let old me lady. Tell you.
Old lady dude.
Yeah.
Do you got chocolate?
In fact, I do. I think I figure prominently into this story, you'll see. You understand that the chocolate vampire is not the only person I've ever interacted with who is, you know, wise with the ways of chocolatiering.
You don't say.
When I was younger, because this is a story that took place in the past, I used to know Mr. Girardelli himself when he was first starting out.
Oh, wow. Like the guy with the factory in that place?
That's right. He's a man who is intimately familiar with the ways of chocolating in the less magical ways. I do have a bit of a sweet tooth, I'll admit it. Which is why I'm kind of taking a kin to you.
Yeah.
I see what's going on
here. Can't deny it.
Yeah.
Oh, but the point. My old mind does wander.
That sounds exactly correct.
When old Ghirardelli died, I inherited his wealth of chocolate.
Oh.
The money he siphoned off to other things, but the chocolate I kept.
You got the chocolate?
I can have chocolate delivered anywhere at any time.
That's like a superpower, bro.
It basically is.
It is like a superpower, bro. In that...
It supports people everywhere.
Yes.
Hey, look at that. I'm a punster.
Now, which one of you is going to do these lines I've set up?
Oh, I can do...
I'm pre-gamed. I'm already tasting colors. Go ahead.
Your turn, Chucky.
All right.
This is the sound of drug use.
You guys are a mean rail.
I'm pretty sure that was just like powdered sugar.
Yes.
Guys, did anybody see my powdered sugar cut with flour?
Why is my nose all cakey now?
Sorry, Cody, did you need this for something?
That's okay, I'll just bake with what I have here.
Well, I think we've run out of interesting conversation here.
Hey, Cody, weren't you talking about spiking the punch?
I was going to get around to it. And then there was like gravy and a blender and a sword fight.
Yeah.
With swords made of chocolate. I don't know.
So while you go down to do that, would you mind grabbing me a bottle of sherry?
A bottle of what?
Sherry. Not cooking sherry.
Okay. I will definitely grab you sherry as soon as I know what it is. I have no idea what that is.
You don't know what sherry is?
What proof is it? Like, can we start from that? That's how my brain catalogs things. I don't know what sherry is.
Okay. In that case, if you could just find like a dessert wine or like a nice port or something like that.
Okay. That's a little more accessible. I love port. I love wine because it's alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
And me, Cody.
That's why I'm asking you. Yeah, yeah. You know where it all is.
It's just the last time we had a party, the labeling system on the shelves got all mixed up. And so it's going to take me a really long time to find stuff that's not basically just straight liquor. And so I'd be down there for like hours looking for a port sherry. I thought you had that
all like memorized, like the back of your hand, or like is people memorize those or something? I don't know.
I don't know what the back of my saying. Yeah. No, I did have it memorized and somebody messed up my system.
Oh.
Remember the party?
Not really.
It was in July sometime.
Which one?
Before the bender, but after the rock and roll disaster.
Oh, okay. Dang, dude.
Yeah.
So
it's chaotic down there.
Okay. So you don't know where any of the wines are then?
I mean, I know what room they're in. Mm-hmm. I could theoretically find a wine in a room, but I can't guarantee that it's like safe to drink.
Oh, wow.
For you.
That's fine. Bring up the beef eater, the gin. So I want to make some gin and tonics instead then.
Oh,
and that might actually some of the stuff that's up here.
Okay.
These burritos.
So good news.
Uh-huh.
I remember where the gin is.
Good.
Because I was doing shots of
the beef eater.
The beef eater. Yeah.
Gin.
Yeah. If you feed bees gin, it's hilarious. They get all wobbly in the air. Anyway.
Huh.
I remember where the gin is because I was going to do shots of gin and Tabasco. Amazing. But then I remembered that's one of the doors that's still barricaded from the party. So I can't really get in there without a lot of big, like, heavy equipment or weaponry.
Like a bobcat or troops. Or something.
Yeah, there's some kind of barricade still built up around it. I just haven't gotten around to tearing it down because somebody won't let me bring C4 into the building.
Yeah.
It's you. You or somebody.
Oh.
Yeah.
Was I, like, really sad or something when you asked? Because usually I'd be all right with that.
You probably. You did that mumbly thing you do?
Oh, yeah. I was sad.
Anyway, yeah, big old barricade. So at least I know where the gin is. That's good news, right?
Yeah.
That makes you happy.
So could none of the gin is accessible? Because I did ask for beef eater, but I would actually... Really? I mean, there's a couple with different botanicals that would be nice. Sapphire, Bombay Sapphire.
Ooh, I that stuff has a cool bottle.
Yeah.
So I also remember where that is because I was going to wear it as like a hat. I was going to wear it as a crown. I was going to like tie it to my head.
Reasonable.
And be like, I'm the king of Sapphire. Uh-huh. It was going to be amazing. Luckily, it's not in the room with the beef eater gin.
Yes. Of course not.
No, that'd be ridiculous.
It deserves its own room.
It has its own hallway.
Mm-hmm.
But when we were in the security room, I was checking the cameras and there's actually still a little bit of a riot going on in that hallway from the party last time.
Okay.
Like spray paint and flamethrowers. I mean, you know, a little makeshift, some dancing. It's a little dangerous. And like I said, I don't need C4. I can't clear it out.
Yeah. Okay. Look, that's going to be all right then. Okay.
Well, good.
Just bring out the suds, you know? Get those beers. Get those brewskis up here.
Oh, okay. That's what we have in those craft custom barrels, right?
Yeah, we got a ton of those.
We do have a lot of those.
Yeah.
Luckily, that's not near the riot at all. Like, it's...
Oh, good.
It's good, the next room over, and they haven't broken through the stronghold yet.
Uh-huh.
But... See, funny story. It's really funny.
Huh.
You're going to laugh when you hear this, because it is... Always. That's how funny of a story it is.
Mm.
In order to clear the riot from the beer room, I had to break open all the beer casks and make a big swimming pool out of them.
I thought you said they hadn't gotten there yet.
They haven't gotten there yet recently because I pushed them into the Bombay Sapphire hallway from the beer swimming pool cask room.
Uh-huh.
Like I basically, you know, I took all the part of the casks and made them into a big swimming pool of beer.
Why bother reclaim the beer room if they've destroyed all of the product?
Principle.
Okay, I just don't see what's worth saving.
That's a good point. We have a time machine, right? I can go back and fix that?
Uh-huh.
Okay, I'm going to do that.
You better.
Later. Earlier. Technically, it'll be earlier. Later. I'm going to do it because it's time.
Okay. Well, when you do that, why don't you go ahead and hold off the riot from happening so that all this stuff will be available now?
Sure. That would make sense if this was like Back to the Future.
It makes sense as much as time travel makes sense.
Yeah. Sure. Except, like, you're not going to be happy with me.
That's to be expected.
Because you started the riot.
Okay. All right. I don't understand why we're pointing fingers here. All I want is a drink, and you're trying to make me out to be a monster.
Correct. But I don't think this is so much my fault as it is something I can blame somebody else for.
Okay. Here's something that you can't get out of. Time travel or otherwise.
I don't know. I don't know, Dave.
Bring me the Kraken.
Are you sure?
As sure as I've ever been. As I has ever been.
Esteban!
Har.
Okay, folks. Hey, folks. I just want to give you all a status update real quick. Dinner is going to be late. I'm not sure exactly how late.
Grumble.
We're working on it. You know, it's and it's going to be great. You're going to love it. We're going to have to wait a little while. So.
How long? Clone Dave here. How long?
Clone Dave, we're working that out. It's probably going to be like another hour at least, though.
Okay, so when you say you don't know how long, you mean you don't know.
Yes.
You're not just trying to hide it from us.
Yes, I mean I don't know.
Okay.
Mr. Hansen, the master here.
Oh, hey there, master.
Yes, very good. You know your place. Excellent. So I have been told I was going to be able to read some of my poetry at dinner. How long is pushing this back going to cut into my performance time?
It's going to cut into your performance time. Not at all, because we never agreed to that. So you do not have anything to worry about.
So I should start reading now, is what you're saying?
Sure, yeah.
Excellent.
Upon the darkening shadows of the cold.
Anyone else?
Hey, yeah, I have a question.
Oh, yeah, hey,
Sven. Here, the Viking conqueror of all. I'm the one that brought the lance. You may know me from that.
Yes. Yes, the lance.
I was just curious, No one has approached me at all yet about carving the turkey, and I did bring all of these cool, sharp things.
Right, yes. Turkey's probably not happening anymore. The turkey is... Well,
What has happened to the turkey, John?
It blew up.
It blew up what?
It exploded.
The turkey.
The turkey exploded, yes.
What about the backup turkey? You have a backup turkey, don't you?
The backup turkey. Okay, so here's what's going on. I'm going to level with you guys.
Do level.
I was working in the kitchen.
Late last night.
Getting the turkey ready. And, we were already running a little behind. And the turkey all of a sudden exploded. And it exploded because Cody had flown his time machine. Set his time machine to arrive there right at that position. Coming from the future. And he just got out of the time machine, grabbed the backup turkey, and ran off somewhere. I don't know where.
I have a question.
Oh, yes. Old Lady Jitters?
That's right. Did you end up making the sugar cookies?
The sugar cookies. Yes, we did make the sugar cookies.
With the powdered sugar?
Yes.
Thank you, that's all.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we had to throw them away when we found out that the powdered sugar was cocaine.
No, where's the trash? I have something to throw away.
Hey, John. John.
Oh.
It's me, Chainsaw Juggling Morty.
Yeah, hi, Morty.
So, listen. I know I said you could use some of my chainsaws to carve the turkey.
Uh-huh.
But now that there is no turkey, I need to get them back. And I got one back. What is all this weird stuff on it? And is it going to be on the rest of them?
Right, so that is ectoplasm from the time travel event. So they probably are all going to have that on them because when Cody came back into the kitchen, I don't know which Cody it was, if it was our Cody or future Cody. He had a lot of blood on him, and he brought several chainsaws along into the time machine. So I'm assuming that wherever he ended up in the timeline, that's where your chainsaws will be.
So it's not so much where as a question of when?
Yes.
So, like in an hour?
Could be. Could be in an hour, could be a few years from now. I don't know how on top of the whole time travel thing Cody is.
Probably not very much.
Sometimes he just remembers, I was going to go back in time and fix that thing. And then he does it.
That sounds about right. Okay.
Hey there. My name is Ron. You may not know me. I was the guy that was recording the contact information for your podcast a little while there before I finally escaped the prison.
Yeah. Hi, Ron. Welcome back.
What? Ron Thanks. Escaped?
Very surprised to be invited back. Came with a whole lot of trepidation about this. Mm-hmm. Basically, I'm just curious to know, now that we've stalled for a while, do you have any more information about when dinner is going to be? And what can you say about the stories I've been hearing of people choking on corns?
Oh, yes. So there was a little bit of a problem with the tamale burritos that Esteban brought.
Sounds like good old home country cooking.
It was a fantastic idea, except that Esteban did not remove the corn husks from the tamales before wrapping them in the tortillas. And so now we have choking on corn husks.
I see. All right. Well, as long as there's booze in the punch, I think we'll all be happy.
Right. So other problem there.
Hmm.
Which is that I think what Cody came back in time to fix is there's a riot going on near the liquor cabinet or something.
That's so.
Yeah. So I think Cody came back in time to fix that now, and he hasn't figured out yet that he needs to go back to July to actually fix that.
All right. I'm old and confused, and you're making it worse.
Mm-hmm.
I better go sit down.
Okay.
John.
Yes.
Me Grog.
Oh, hi, Grog.
Brother Thog.
Yes, yes. How are you doing?
Hungry.
Hungry. Well, I believe that your brother brought a meat-flavored fruitcake.
Brother Pansy had cooked meat in fruitcake. Where raw meat?
Ah, Slog here. I also want to know where the meats are.
Oh, me Slog. Me talk good.
I said also.
Okay. I get that there's some sibling rivalry going on here, but...
I'm a cousin.
His side of family, very bougie.
I don't even look like him.
A little.
Okay, well, if you're going to start clubbing each other, we do prefer that you do that outside.
Club?
Good idea.
I club you with giant bobcat.
Grog think that unlikely.
Grog will find out.
Okay, so that's the status on dinner.
Dinner?
Dinner!
Yeah,
meat,
not
meat.
Not
meat,
happening
meat,
for a while.
Meat. Meat.
Not happening meat, for a while. Might meat, not happen at meat, all at this
team,
juncture.
Team meat.
Team
meat. Meat team.
Meat.
Slog part of team meat.
Okay.
Represent.
Cool.
Slog applied to team meat.
That's great.
Still
that's
intern.
Great. Everyone's
Slog
so-
waiting to hear. On final status.
John made of meat.
Okay,
John,
I'm gonna go check on
John.
Yeah, I'm gonna go check on dinner.
John.
All right, guys.
Well, this is a disaster.
This is not as exciting in the right way that I wanted it to be.
No, the party was supposed to be fun. Everyone shows up, they commingle. We have like interesting conversations between interesting people.
Yeah.
Just like the old times.
And get drunk.
Oh, yeah. This is a lot.
Yeah.
This is a lot harder than navigating underground dungeon complexes and saving Christmas.
Yeah. And friggin' Mike and Chris don't even show up to our stuff anymore.
Yeah. Jerks.
We sent them specific hand lettered invites. It, with John's blood. How do you turn that down?
Guys, did we... Did we fail?
I mean, I'm used to it. I don't know about you guys.
Like, we've spent so many years doing extraordinary things this time of year. We've lost touch with how to do the basic things of just entertaining. What do we do well? There's nothing, there's no like magical time warp that we have to fix.
No.
Right.
What's something else we do?
Well, we do the podcast.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that.
And we have magical powers of knowing the answers, but only when our listeners ask.
Right.
That's true.
We don't have any listeners here to ask.
Yeah.
Does Clone Dave count?
No. He's never went to school.
I don't know what I expected.
He's a secret clone. I've kept him secret.
I deserve that. That's fair.
Mm-hmm. Hey, you know what we do?
Podcast.
Fall asleep and cry.
Yeah. Fruitwards.
Oh, yours
is a game
answer.
We play utilizing cards of two kinds and colors.
Yes. Red cards are nouns. Green cards are adjectives.
Uh-huh. They are.
We can draw one card of each color.
And improvise
a solution to this problem.
Based on the card. Sorry, did I don't have that one memorized that well. I'm not paying attention when you say it.
John asked me.
Dave.
Yeah?
Draw the cards.
Okay. We're going to solve tonight with intellectual odes.
We are?
Apparently, that's what the deck says.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. So let's get out there.
Uh-huh.
Let's give some odes.
Mm-hmm.
Make them intellectual.
Right.
And salvage this disaster.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
All right.
Awesome. Mm-hmm.
So
let's go out there first.
Okay.
You're like cranking up to punch or something verbally. Let's get out there. All right.
Hey,
everybody. Let's up. Hey,
hey, hello. Whistle.
Dave, I can't whistle.
Dave's not time for that.
Sorry, got carried away.
Jello is after dinner.
Hey, everybody, just focus up here for a second.
He's such a good orator.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. What's an ode again? It's like something about a specific thing that's like saying how good it is.
Devotional, yeah, kind of thing, yeah.
Is it an ode to joy?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but that... Yeah. All right, listen up, everybody. I want to tell you about something important.
Oh, here we go.
Is fruitcake?
Fruitcake.
That figures prominently into it, but it is not exclusively about fruitcake.
Boo!
No, hold it. Save your judgment. I think you'll like this. Christmas time is a time for joy. It's a time where people get together and they say, "Ahoy, good friend, let's gather our cheer. Let's bring together people. Let's bring together beers and cheers one another in the most merriest of times. Let's make this party right by saying words that rhyme." And if you happen to have a turkey go missing, or you walk into a room where an old lady is kissing a chocolate man of great stature and birth, and you think to yourself, "Hell, this really is a diverse earth, full of so many people, so many friends and kin, that, well, sometimes you gotta say shit and throw the towel in. Not every party can be a raging success, but maybe if you try, maybe, I guess, if everyone forgives you for dropping the ball, then a great time can be had by all after all." Fruitcake.
That was marvelous, Dave.
Thank you.
Approaching plebeian.
Okay. Guys, I think it worked.
Like, that was really good,
they've
dude.
Stayed like focused and quiet the entire time almost.
Yeah.
You guys, one of you do one. Do an ode. Make it a little more intellectual.
Okay,
maybe.
Okay.
Yeah, that was emotional.
Yeah, very much.
Immanuel Kant once said a lot of stuff about philosophy. He was German, so I guess he was good at that. Just like all of us are trying to be good at Christmas. We're trying really hard to be good at Christmas, but we're falling kind of short. But that's okay, because we're all friends here, right?
That's right. I'm getting very close with Mr. Chocolate Man.
See? Old Lady Jitters gets it.
He gave me a kiss and not the Hershey kind.
The spirit of Christmas flows through us all at this wonderful time of year.
Is that what I feel?
Grog uncomfortably aroused.
See, now it's getting to Grog even. His ex-girlfriend is a rock. We're all growing tonight. And that's what Christmas is about. Being together with friends. And being okay if things don't turn out quite the way you expected. It's all right. We all love one another. Some more than others. Old Lady Jitters, you're making us uncomfortable.
Stop watching if you don't like it.
Okay. But anyway, I think we can all agree that dinner or no dinner, there's nothing that we would trade for each other's company this evening. Amen? Is that how this...
That's not how I feel, the amen part. My gods don't want me to say that.
Okay.
But I feel what you're saying about friendship.
Yeah?
Yeah, you need friends to back you up when you get into a fight, you know?
True.
You need family in order to, you know, continue the humans.
Yeah,
You need people to fight.
Okay, well...
And someone has to make these cool weapons.
True. And you do make cool weapons, Sven.
Weapons are the best.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. So I'm basically on board.
Cool.
And I'm thinking I'm saying that it's good, but 95% convinced.
Okay. Well, Cody?
Yeah, that's... Wait, what? What are we doing? Is this the alphabet game? I kind of tuned out, sorry.
We're all giving intellectual odes on the subject of Christmas and its true meaning.
Oh, okay.
Basically, it's all down to you to convince me it's not a disaster.
Oh.
That puts me into a rage when I then go kill everybody.
We don't want Sven to rage, you guys.
No.
Shit, it's up to me?
Okay, no stress, no problem.
That's fine. Stupid Sven is stupid raging. The beef eater, he'd be okay. All right, listen up, you jerks. Christmas time is great. We're going to have some meat fruitcake, but Casey, he already ate. So I thought to myself, I'll make a time machine, and I'll go back to the past, and I'll fix that stupid riot, and then this Christmas party will last. I can't do all the great math and all the shit to make it work, so I blamed it all on Dave, because he still thinks I'm a jerk. I thought, what if we had a party, and everyone was there, and they'd throw up all their hats, and they'd put things in the air, and we'd have a fantastic riot, and that's how it got out of hand. And then I thought, I'll barricade them all, and they made their own country land. And so now they're a sovereign nation, and we have to declare trade, but that's all kind of irrelevant. Anyway, I need my spade. Before I make this next point, I think I was killing zombies or ghouls. But anyway, this is a party, and parties are supposed to have rules. Like, don't stick your face in the punch bowl, Esteban. Like, that shit's for everyone to drink.
Arr, sorry.
And Jitters over there, I don't even want to look. It's pushing my stomach to the brink.
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah, gross. But really, the spirit of Christmas is about hanging out and getting blasted. Unless you don't like to drink, in which case, you know, you can stay half-masted. So, I forgot where I was going. I think I need to get some eggs. Bacon, grease, turkey. That's my shopping list. This speech is on its last legs. So listen up, guys. Have some fun. Sven, don't break my shit.
You got it, bro.
That guy's the best. I'm gonna go time traveling. I'll be back in a bit.
A little anticlimactic.
A little bit, yeah. Well, sorry, everybody. I guess the evening's kind of a bust. But, who's this?
Yes. Who is it? Someone at the door.
Oh, well, hi there, folks. This is the party, isn't it?
Wimberly, you made it.
Yeah, hello, everyone. It's Waverly Rudigore III. I'm very happy to be here. How is everyone?
Not great.
Grog want meat. Grog want John meat.
Oh, well, that's a pity, because all I have is this 25 pounds of prime rib.
Gasps.
Mr. Rudigore, sorry it took me a while to get all of the trunk stuff. I have your sausages, and I have your beers.
Sausages.
And the cart full of other pies.
Perfect. Good job. Good job. What was your name again?
My name's
Small Boy.
Tiod.
Tiod, yes. Yes, it sounds delightfully foreign.
Someday.
Tiod,
yeah.
Why don't you bring all the things into the big kitchen room?
I will, sir. It's my pleasure to be your boy servant, and I hope that someday I can grow up to be a man servant.
Yeah, well, we'll work on that. First, you need to be able to skin these chipmunks without, crying all the time.
Yes, sir.
Tiod, watch out for the booby traps in the kitchen.
Oh.
Wait, so you've got a trunk full of meat?
And other assorted delectables?
Yes, I am a taxidermist, after all. You can't put the meat back in there. It would go bad.
I guess I never really thought about it.
I didn't either.
So you've been
kind of through it somewhere.
Taxidermying cows?
On occasion, yes.
Huh.
Beautiful creatures.
The only animals smarter than man.
Meats? Pies? Why, it's like we have everything we need, essentially. He said beer?
I think he said beer.
Yeah, there's beers and...
I'm gonna check the beer. Yep, it's beer. I'm a little drunk.
And I have, I brought my bar cart. It's not much. It's only about 50 gallons of assorted spirits, mixers, and garnishes.
Wow.
This will last me all night.
That's amazing.
Right? Thank you, Wimbledon.
You saved the night.
Have I?
I mean, all of our speechifying and odifications are fine, but...
Acceptable at best.
We were trying to convince people to accept something unacceptable.
Yeah, that's
we're
that's
bullshitting kinda... them with the
yeah.
the all this fake Christmas love in action. It's
yeah, love is fake.
You know the important thing you did, the important lesson that you taught everyone here?
What did I do?
Sometimes you just have to fucking stall for time. Huh. Sometimes you just have to waste a little time.
I am uncomfortable with that being the final words of this. Fixed it. Hey, thanks everybody.
Hey.
Yes, thank you.
Thanks so much for hanging out for our Christmas special.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Good night.
We hope you enjoyed this.
Thanks very much for hanging out, you guys. We took a little bit of a different tack this year with our Christmas party.
Mm-hmm.
Usually it doesn't go off with any hitches.
That's right. And there were a ton of them this time. If you had trailers, boy, we were ready for you.
That was good.
Thank you. It's like the Bobcat thing.
Yep. That joke will never die.
It won't live either.
Because
it's not cractively running.
Cractively.
No pun intended. Anyway, we hope you enjoyed hearing from some familiar characters, some new, and
some really weird.
We will, take your feedback with a grain of salt. We won't take your feedback. What's going on here?
I think it's usually if you have good things to say about the podcast, we'll listen to that.
Okay.
And if you have bad things to say about the podcast,
go to Twitter.
You should tweet them to me at Jay Hansen himself so that they'll get lost and never read.
Lost and never read. Right.
Yes.
Thanks everybody for voting.
Yes. You guys are amazing.
Mm-hmm. We got our top 10 and we will be back to share it with you.
Yes indeed. Our annual best of clip show.
We're going to get so hyphy. People still say hyphy?
No.
Is that a thing anymore?
No, I think that died in 2003 or something.
Really? Crunk? Are we getting crunk? Crunked.
Oh.
Crunked up?
No.
No.
No?
No.
Also
an aughts thing.
Yeah. Bee's knees?
Ooh.
Anyway.
Also an aughts thing. All right. So until the top 10, thanks for listening. My name is Dave.
I'm John.
I'm Cody.
And we wasted all of the year.
We did. Lit AF.
Bon voyage is a thing currently still said.
Yes. Good night, folks.
Congratulations, you've made it to the end of another episode of Wasting All the Time, a podcast. If you enjoyed this show, then please consider subscribing on Apple Podcasts or Stitcher, or follow us on Spotify. If you really enjoyed the show, then head on over to patreon.com/timewastepod and become a supporter of our time-wasting efforts. Now, that was a lot of things I just threw at you, so if you forget all of that, just head on over to wastingallthetime.com, and there we have all the answers.
Oh, hey, Casey, what's up?
Hi, it's me, Casey, the greatest.
Oh, I'm glad you showed up. I know the studio is a bit of a drive.
No, yeah, I know, but I still came.
That's so great. Did you bring that special drink we talked about?
I did. The one with the yak milk in it. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm still surprised that you can milk a yak with your condition.
Yeah. No, it's, anyone can do it. Apparently they just let you.
So
like if you're strong enough to like grab a yak and wrestle it to the ground and milk it, they don't fuck with you, man.
That's fantastic. So how much did you get?
I got this much, like half a cup.
You wrestled an entire yak to the ground and got half a cup of milk.
I was tired.
Hey, Casey.
Oh, hey, Sven.
You Casey crazy war yak stealing man.
Yeah. Come on. Hit me with the axe.
Yeah.
Oh, I love this guy.
Come on. I'm doing blow.
Yeah.
That was fantastic.
Thank you.
The greatest. Thanks for being a good sport, Casey, and not stabbing me in my sleeve.
Or John. You can stab John in his sleeve.
I was just going to say, now Casey's going to beat the shit out of me. Immanuel Kant, a philosopher of great stature, came up with ideas. I don't know, fucking a cow pasture.
Why fucking cow pasture?
It's not that bad.
He thought of the self. Not so much about Christmas, but if he were here, he wouldn't miss this. He was German, it's true. I looked him up on Wikipedia to be sure.
I really wanted to hear John rhyme with Wikipedia.
I made a terrible mistake in trying to follow you with rhymes.
That's fine.
I want to start over.
That's fine. Yeah. I'll allow it.
Okay.
Judges? Yes.
Yeah.